Capture One Pro 7 now has the ability to store your images in a catalogue. Sessions, which are supported in Capture One 6 and earlier versions, can still be used. First, let's look at how to populate an empty catalogue with some images. There are three ways to populate a catalogue in Capture One Pro 7. Importing images from an existing folder on your hard drive or memory card, shooting tethered from a supported DSLR, or importing an existing catalogue from Media Pro. Capture One Pro 7 will create a new, empty catalogue on startup for the first time, if you chose this option in the startup screens. Otherwise, click on the plus icon in the library tool and choose New Catalogue to name the catalogue and to choose where it is stored on your system. To import images, press the large icon in the center of the screen or the matching icon in the toolbar. Select where to import image files from and click Open. Under Import To, decide where to store the imported images. Choosing Inside Catalog will store the images within the catalog file itself. The image files and catalog file can also be stored in separate locations. This is useful if you want to store your images on external drives or servers. In this case, choose the current location option. Automatic backups can also be set by checking Backup Enabled and setting a location. Decide on the naming format for the imported files. Click here to build any number of naming formats. Using Image Name will retain the existing file name. Finally, metadata and adjustments can be set in the further two menus. Check the Include Existing Adjustments box if you are bringing in raw files that have already been worked on in earlier versions of Capture One. Click Import All Images here and the import process will start. The activity monitor will open, showing the import process. Once the import has finished, the images will appear as thumbnails along the bottom of the screen here. Change the thumbnail display by clicking on one of the three icons. The current catalog is shown here within the library tool. The library tool is used to display and organize the current catalog. You will see that it is split into three sections: fixed, user, and folders. The content of the fixed window cannot be changed and shows fixed albums of all the images in the current catalogue, recent imports, recent captures, and the trash. The user area allows the creation of albums, smart albums, projects, and groups. Any number of projects can be created within a catalogue. Subsequently, that project can contain any number of albums or smart albums. Groups are simply a way of grouping together any number of projects or albums. The hierarchy is very flexible, enabling you to create the image catalogue for your needs. Any number of images can then simply be drag and dropped into an album. Albums and smart albums are the only element that can contain images. To create an album, click on the plus icon in the user area and select New Album. Then simply drag any image or groups of images into the new album. Recently opened catalogues are shown here. Simply select other catalogues to switch between them or open them from the File pull-down menu. Now we have a populated catalogue, let's adjust some images. Capture One Pro 7 uses individual profiles for your camera for delivering the best out-of-the-box results in terms of color rendition, noise reduction, and detail. There is an extensive set of adjustment tools to give you the creative look you desire. Let's look at a simple workflow to get you started. Tool tabs are shown here on the left-hand side. The various tools are placed within these tabs. Hover the mouse over the icon to see the title. First, move to the Color tool tab. Take the white balance picker and choose a neutral area in the image. White balance can also be adjusted by using the sliders here. Images needing the same adjustment from any tool can easily be adjusted by using copy and apply commands. Command click other images that would benefit from the same white balance adjustment. For this operation, it may be helpful to see the images in a multi-view. Click here, and this will tile any selected images. Command clicking further images will add them to the multi-view. To apply the same adjustment from the primary variant, indicated by the solid white border, shift click on the copy apply icon in the toolbar. Shift clicking is a very effective shortcut to copy and instantly apply the adjustment to the selected images. This method works with one adjustment tool. However, it is just as simple to copy global adjustments from one image to several as above. Use the copy and apply adjustments command in the adjustments pull down menu. Note the shortcut keys for fast access. Each tool has a number of icons on the top bar. If a question mark is visible here, then it gives access to useful online help about that particular tool. If an A is present, this will action auto-adjustment of the current tool on any selected images. The next gives access to the copy apply command, as seen earlier. Use the modifier keys to change the behavior. The next resets the tool to default settings. The reset action will apply for all selected images. Hold down the Option key to temporarily reset the tool. This is very useful for viewing the effect a tool has. The next manages presets. For example, tools can have a preset value saved and recalled within the same menu. Take time to browse the tool tabs to see the extent of adjustments Capture One Pro 7 offers. Other tutorials available on phase1.com go into more detail on different tools. Once you are happy with the adjustments applied to your images, they can be exported in a variety of popular image formats. Select one or more images to export and then click on the Export Variants icon in the toolbar. The export dialog will open. Work through the dialog to set up the export parameters. First, choose a location for the exported files. Choose a naming format for the exports. Leaving the format set to image name will retain the raw file name in the export. Click here to adjust the naming format. The recipe is the parameters which will form the basis of the image output. For example, the file format and scale. Many different file formats can be selected from the pull-down menu here. Decide on the other parameters and then advance to the Adjustments tab. Within this tab, it is possible to disable the sharpening set within Capture One, a useful feature if the image is going to be sharpened after further post-production work. Finally, the metadata tab lists options to include various metadata. Click on Export to complete the process. The activity monitor will open showing the progress of the export. However, as this is a background process, you can continue to work on your images. To learn more about Capture One Pro 7, don't forget to use the help icons around the application and view additional tutorial videos available on phase1.com.